You just, you know, with digital video, and, you know, this is all shot on mini DV tapes, you've got it, you know, a bag, you can put it over your shoulder, pick up a tripod like that, and out the door, and you can start making films. So all of the documentary footage, I shot myself, did the sound myself, just with a, you know, a small kit, and you can create, you know, anything with that. But to really capture her performance, then I needed to get much more investment to do justice to it, to shoot on film, to create a show that for the camera would have that Grace Jones kind of graphic force. You know, the band are fantastic, but I wanted to create something that was theatrical, because Grace loves theatre. She sees herself in a theatrical context, more than a rock and roll context, really. So I wanted to create the conditions for her performance to kind of happen. And that took a lot of time, because it takes time to raise finance. You know, it wasn't like I was doing it against another form, but, you know, it's just that I'm just not the person to call if you want to make a kind of a biography channel film. It's just not, doesn't turn me on as a filmmaker. I like to kind of be in the world, freewheeling, creating material. I love ideas, and, you know, I spoke a lot with Grace, and, you know, a lot of what I learned about what she feels about performance and what she feels about her life informs how I put the film together. So, you know, I remember once she made, I remember her saying, oh, you mean those films where people sit and talk about you who didn't even know you? You know, so we weren't doing that. This is actually, like, if you think of films like Don't Look Back, you know, this is also a very classic way to make a documentary about music, which is simply to be in the moment with those people, because you're making a documentation. You're not doing a commentary. You're not looking back and say, let's all think about the time when we weren't here. This film is saying, be here now. For 2 hours, you're going to be intimately in Grace Jones' world. That's the kind of film I make, the films that I like to see. You know, so it's, and I like to make a document, because it's a little tiny gesture against the truth of our mortality. That, you know, you make a document and it's there. And that's what film is, you know. Film is, you know, as a film theorist said, it's death at 24 frames a second. We're asked to say this, but the truth is, it's just a kind of, you know, she's obviously a fantastic person. I love the way she thinks. I love the way she expresses herself. And to film, for me, that was just like, I felt like the cat who got the cream, you know, because she was so beautiful to frame, and, you know, to sort of understand how to frame her, and, you know, capturing moments. People say to me, oh, were you scared when she was shouting to Robbie Shakespeare on the phone? You know, I was really trying to make sure that, you know, I wasn't over-recording the sound or the sharp, you know, should I make a close-up or a wide, you know. So I have to be very craft-orientated even when I'm filming. So it's all these different parts of you that you kind of need to engage when you're making documentary, because you don't have a script. So then you get to the edit, and that is very exciting, because you kind of have to find your film in the material. And it's not like you have an imposed idea from the start. And it's not like I had an agenda. Oh, I want to say this about Grace Jones. I had to discover what the film could do, what the film said, what those moments of her in all of their truth could reveal, and make it as complex and as multi-layered and multi-narrative as possible, really, so that it's like a rich meal, you know.